Hello, my name is Norliana Natasha, and I'm 17 years old. I'm from SMK Cangkat Lada, Perak. I'm going to share a story with you titled A Perfect Time for Pandas, and here the story goes. One day, Jack and Annie had planned to go to the treehouse before school. Today was the day to find the fourth thing to save Penny. Good morning, sleepyheads. I made you egg sandwiches, their mom said. We have to head to school early, said Jack. Their mom wrapped up their sandwiches and put them in a paper bag. After that, they headed to the treehouse and going inside it. No time at all passed back in there. That is a guidebook to China. Annie unrolled the scroll. They need to find a healthy food in China. Jack looked around again and there are a small glass bottle glinted. Used only once. Take one sip and grow to 5 times your size. The magic lasts for 1 hour, written on the bottle's label. It was daylight outside they came to China in modern times. They landed in Wolong Town, May 12, 2008. Jack took the little scroll from his backpack and read it. Wait, did you say giant pandas? Said Annie. Yes, said Jack. We have to go there now, said Annie. Then, they ran bikes at Wolong Town Bicycle Shop to the Panda Center. My name is Dr. Ling, the young Chinese woman said to the group. Welcome to the largest giant panda reserve in the world. Soon, they went to the yard with their panda keepers, Master Li. But there are no signs of a giant panda. Bingbing is very shy, said Master Li. That's the name of a giant panda. A few minutes later, they saw a giant panda was climbing down the trunk of a maple tree. Hello, Bingbing, said Master Li. After they played and recorded Bingbing's behavior, they quickly picked at a few more pandas before leaving. They grabbed their bikes and go. Suddenly, the roadway trembled and everything around them began shaking and moving. They put on the brakes and jumped off their bikes. Earthquake, said Jack. We have got to go back, said Annie. They both scrambled up to the road. Jack reached into his backpack and took out the potion. They decided to rescue the pandas first. Jack took a sip and started to grow. You are huge, said Annie. Jack picked and placed her on one of his giant shoulders and went back there. When they reached there, staff members were rushing around. When Master Li and Dr. Ling caught sight of Jack, they both stopped dead and gaped at him. Hi there, can we help? Annie called. Yes, thank you. We need all the help we can get, said Dr. Ling. Bingbing is missing, said Master Li. Bingbing must have run off into the woods, said Jack. They went to the woods and kept moving until Jack stopped. Bingbing was sitting and snoring. They kept closer to the panda. When she saw Jack and Annie, she let out a bellow. Annie gently pat the giant panda's furry head. High up in a tree, there were 2 small pandas. They caught the cubs. 2 small pandas tore down the tree trunk. Jack and Annie carried the cubs through the bush until more whimpering panda sounds made them stop. A 3rd cub was peeking out from behind an old tree stump. Jack took it along with the other 2. We will take them to the nursery, said Dr. Ling. For a moment, the helicopter from military has arrived. They are bringing medical supplies and food. Jack went to see Bingbing and found Master Li feeding a bread to Bingbing. They call it panda bread. It's very healthy. Jack took some panda bread and said goodbye to Bingbing and Master Li. On his way, he saw the helicopter had landed on the kindergarten playground. The helicopter lifted off the ground and buzzed away from the panda center. Soon, the pilot landed in a large field. Jack and Annie carried the sleeping cubs out and handed them over to the woman. We still have to find the special food, said Annie. Jack took out the panda bread from his backpack. It's called panda bread and it's very healthy. They go to Camelot from the magic tree house to help bring Penny back to life. They land in the orchard. Daddy and Kathleen hug Jack and Annie. They all emerge from the orchard and go to Merlin's garden house. The little penguin was as gray and lifeless as stone. Jack took out the 4 things and were lit by the circle of glowing lantern light, along with Penny. Daddy, the spellcaster, raised his arms and exclaimed, Spell be broken. Penny, come back to life. They all wait another long moment. The baby penguin's body turned from dull gray to soft white. Teddy starts crying and longing too. The trumpeters means that Merlin and Morgan have returned from Avalon. Goodbye, said Teddy. Kathleen hugged Jack and Annie. Bye, Penny, Annie said. I wish we could go home, Annie said, pointing to a picture of the Frog Creek Woods. No time at all had passed in there while they were gone. They unwrapped their sandwiches from Jack's backpack and took a bite. Then they hurried through the woods, finally on their way to school. The end.